my name's Robert Dean Steele, and this is your daily Bible class. Well, we're in the book of 1 John chapter 5. Listen to what John says in verses 1 right through to verse number 5. He says, everyone who believes that Jesus Christ is born of God. And whoever loves the Father loves his child as well. So he says simply this, if you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, he says, you are born of God. You have become what Jesus was talking about in John chapter 3 when he came to Nicodemus and said, a man must be born again. He's talking about being born of the Spirit, not born of the flesh. That which is flesh is flesh. That which is spirit is spirit. And he says, when you know that Jesus Christ is who Jesus Christ said he was, when you know that Jesus Christ proved what he said by his death, his burial, and his resurrection, when you know that Jesus Christ showed himself alive with many infallible proofs, when you yourself have discovered the eternal and abundant life, I want to tell you something, it changes everything. And he goes on to say, and because of that, you will know that the Father will love his child. You know that you're a child of God and that he loves you. This is how we know that we are and love the children of God, by loving God and carrying out his commands. He says, this is the way that people know that you are his disciples, by the way that you carry out his commands. You do what God wants you to do. You don't make it an option. You don't make it a suggestion. You are a follower of him. You follow what he wants you to do. He says, jump. You say, how high, oh God, do you want me to do it? You say, Lord, you want me to go here? You want me to go there? You are a soldier. I love how Jesus responded to the centurion who said, listen, Jesus, just say the word and my servant will be well. He says, because I'm a man who follows orders. When my commander tells me to go, he says, I go. And when I tell my soldiers to do something, they do it. Jesus said, that's great faith. He knows that the life is a life of obedience. Then he goes, in fact, this love for God will help us to keep his commands, and his commands are not burdensome. Some people get the idea, well, the commandments of God are incredibly burdensome. Jesus said this in Matthew chapter 11, verse 20. It says, come unto me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. God, John was basically reemphasizing what Jesus was talking about when he says, when he gives you a yoke, it is a fitted yoke. You know, folks, we only have been really given one command, and that is to basically love the Lord with every fiber of our being, and we are called to love those made in the image of God. That means everybody, but especially those who are of the household of faith. And then we're called simply to go into all the world and preach the gospel. That's pretty straightforward stuff. It's not rocket science. So he says these commandments are really not burdensome because you're doing all of this through the motivation of love. Then he says, and this, for everyone is born of God, overcomes the world. Oh, isn't that great to know? The victory is this, that he who overcome the world, even our faith. He says, listen, you need to know something today. There's a flat thing that you need to know, and that is that you are an overcomer. You're not a victim. You are a victor. You're not going to be overcome. You're going to be an overcome. You're not going to be conquered. You're going to be more than a conqueror. I love that. I love the fact that you and I are more than conquerors through Jesus Christ. He says it'll even overcome our lack of faith sometimes. You know, we are filled with doubt from time to time. Sometimes say, oh, we're going through hard times, folks. It happens. And then he says, even in those moments when we simply put our trust in God, it'll even overcome those things that attack our faith. He says, and he who is the one who has overcome the world, he asks the question, who's the one that has overcome the world? That's the question. The only one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. He says, you want to overcome? Then you need to believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. You have to believe that he is God's representative. You need to believe that his death, his burial, his resurrection, his broken body, his shed blood was the very thing that gave you victory. And when you do that, no matter what the devil throws at you, doesn't matter if pleasure, passion, materialism comes against you, doesn't matter what the devil says, doesn't matter what the world says, doesn't matter what mankind said, you are going to overcome. Because your faith, your hope, your victory, all of those things are grounded in the love of God and the fact that Jesus Christ gave you and has given you the ability to overcome everything that comes your way. I want you today to be an overcomer. I want you to be today a victor. And all of it's based in the love of God. In a great promise today. My name is Robert Dean Steele. This is your daily Bible class. And you have yourself a great and godly.